Hi, my name is Pat Winter, and I am a crazy quilter who recently discovered junk journaling and fell in love with it. So you'll see me often, because I really enjoy working with the beautiful papers and kits that are available on Etsy and various places. So I want to share with you a journal I made, recently finished, called Forever Adored, and it's by M&J Rustic Creations. Now, I've used elements from several other kits, like G Curve, Victoria Designs, My Porch Prints, Artie Mays, Screech Owl Studio, Tsunami Rose, Era MJ Shop, Adore Australia, and Firefly Studio, Happiness and Crafting, and the digital I used to create the cover was by Allegra Digital. So anyway, but the main kit is by M&J Rustic Creations on Etsy. So what I've done is used a clasp, a jewelry clasp, because it is a three signature journal, and it's not really exploding, but it's pretty full. So I'm just basically going to flip through it fairly quick. Just I try to use a lot of journaling cards and tickets and a few empty pages. It's really hard to leave pages bare for a crazy quilter, let me tell ya. But I did try, like there. So anyway, I just kind of filled it full of little places to journal, add notes and such, and added some little covered paper clips that you can clip your own things down. And I just love the papers and stuff that you can find. Just a couple of tags. Place for journaling. This is just a little booklet to write down some thoughts and poems or happenings of the day. And this is actually a vintage Victorian greeting card that I have in my collection. So I scanned it and printed it out and cut it to make cards to just slip into my journal so I could share the vintage, give it kind of repurpose and spread it along the little vintage cards. I think they're adorable. And of course some more tickets, and all of these are backed and ready to journal on. This is a little journal booklet, just a little paper clip, just a little journaling booklet that you can write your thoughts in and put little tickets and little stubs in there, possibly. I'll put that together later. And more tickets and journaling cards, paper clips. Some tuck spots in here. I think these are inserts that G. Kerr taught. She has a video out on them. And this is just a little tiny paper clip holding an envelope on that has a paper inside matching, so you can jot a note or send a little note to somebody. Just little journaling cards that I stitched around and added a little sari ribbon. All the laces I used are vintage because I've been collecting for years. That's just a little dangly from a paper clip with an envelope with some writing material inside. And this, I just love this. I wish I would have picked up more. I found it Tuesday morning. It's just a little notepad, but I love the shape. And then it's narrow, and I tucked it in here with a little pin that I made. I can't remember whose tutorial this was, but I will write it in underneath. But some people say they're uncomfortable to use, so I made it a little more narrow, and it's pretty comfortable. So anyway, there's that. More writing materials. These were index cards that I dyed with tea stained, and the lines came off, but that's fine. It's gives you more space to write with. This is a cabinet card that a friend taught me how to make, and I made it in her studio, and she has the die cut for it, and it was so fun to watch her cut these out, and they're just perfect. They just look so vintage. Now this is from Shabby Doodah. Tina made this Bursting Bloom envelope pocket, and I just think it's adorable. You just put some fussy cut flowers on an old envelope, and you can just use it as a pocket. I thought that was pretty neat. So anyway, just a paper cut liner. This is just a little envelope with a matching note inside that you can ship off to someone or keep it for yourself. This is another insert, I believe, by G. Kurtz, the other half of the other page. And just some journaling cards. And more little places to put notes. And this little girl, this is a Tim Holtz, and I thought that was adorable. And it would go with the Forever Adored, so I stuck it in here. And this is a paper clip holding an envelope on. And in the envelope is more writing material. And some vintage metallic trim. This is just a little notebook with several pages to jot down some ideas or memories. I just love those from Front Porch Prints. I printed them, the butterflies on vellum. And this is just a pocket between the pages that I just put two pieces of paper in, basically, because sometimes you just want a piece of paper, a big piece of paper. So that's what I did in there, nothing fancy. Here's an envelope with some writing material inside and some vintage mother of pearl, a little heart charm, more tags, and more tags and writing material, and then on the back, this is a vintage piece of lace to tuck in this little booklet. It's a number 4 flip-out booklet by G. Kerr, and this will be tucked in the back. It's for little notes. These are just little tags that you can put in the pockets, and then it opens up to a little notebook and a pocket for another little tag to write some notes. And over here you can put in whatever you want. So it's kind of a handy little thing. And then on the back, of course, I had to put the Adored, because that's the main kit. And it's a 3 signature journal, and I just made a boho bead and put some my porch prints, tags, and just some various beads and a broken earring, broken jewelry, and just a little cherished tag and a key, and stuff that I would usually use in my crazy quilting. So I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching. Bye.